This is the Red Podcast, the podcast for experts. You've got a message to spread. I'm going to help you do that, help you make money with it, and help you attract the people that are interested in that message, help you change the world. That's what you want to do. There are a number of different ways to do that: books, public speaking, podcasting. And over the next month, maybe a little longer than that, I'm going to let you follow me on a journey that includes all three. Something that I have not mentioned lately is that I have been working on a book for the last 3 years. I thought it would be done a couple of years ago. Thought it would be done about 3 years ago originally. But the book that you start is not the book that you end up finishing. This one's been a long process, and I've done it before. I knew what I was getting into. Right now, I'm about 90 days out working with a team of editors. Just heard from one today. She told me the book is strong. Expect something from her within a couple of weeks. The subject of the book is how to use podcasting as a tool to spread your message. It's a lot like what we talk about here on Red Podcast, except it is specifically focused on podcasting. And once this book comes out, I'm going to be talking a lot more about podcasting. But until then, I will be focusing on the book process, the writing process, coming up with the idea, the publishing process, launching the book, selling the book, making impact with the book. If you've ever thought about writing a book, if you're in the middle of writing a book, maybe you're like me, you're 2 or 3 years in, you said, I thought this was going to be a little bit easier than it is. You're going to like this. I'm going to approach this subject in a different way, something you probably haven't heard before, because this book is not only a book for me, this is in a lot of ways a career change. You may know if you listen to Red Podcast that my background is in the music industry. 20-something years, I was focusing on entertainment marketing. Now, I say music industry because my work primarily was in the music industry, but because music industry was one of the first entertainment industries to move toward the internet, I soon started working in the book industry, film, television. Over the years, I've worked with hundreds of musicians, dozens of other types of entertainers, comics, actors, models, lifestyle brands such as Red Bull and other brands that are specifically marketing to the entertainment industry. And what happened to me when I turned about probably 40 years old? It's like a switch flipped. The industry that I'd started in so many years ago wasn't the industry that I was working in. When I got into the music industry, I was excited. I've been a working musician myself. I loved the music industry. Then I found myself becoming part of a machine, and it was like I was working in a factory. But one of the cool things about it, and this has to do with my transition, was that I did have a background in media. I'd worked in radio doing promotion. I'd been doing hosting, host a syndicated show still called Music Business Radio. It's been going on since 2005. I'd seen broadcasting from a variety of different ways. When I started in broadcasting, this was in the early 90s. I was still in college. We were actually taping on tape. And when I would make a mistake, I would jockey the tape back and forth, find out where my mistake was, mark it with a pencil, get a razor blade, literally cut a chunk of tape out, take the two loose ends that were left, tape them back together, and that's how I edited myself on radio. Then podcasting came along. About 2005, that's when I got into it. And I saw the same thing happening for radio and for audio programs that I'd seen in the music industry. It was easier to record. It was easier to edit. It was easier to distribute. That was the part of the music industry that I loved. The new technology that let us record, edit, distribute, get our music out to the world, we had it in radio now. And I wanted to take everything that I'd learned from marketing musicians, film, television, other types of entertainment in this way, and bring that knowledge into a whole new world of people, people that were trying to make the world better, educate people, encourage people, inspire people. That's how I ended up in podcasting. That's why the new book is about how to market yourself with a podcast. So over the next month, maybe a few weeks after that, here are the things that we're going to talk about. I'm going to talk about hiring and firing an editor. The first 3 years of this project had the same editor that got me through my last book. She's a great editor, a great person, a lot of fun to work with, but it just wasn't happening. I will be talking about finding new editors, trusting them with a project that you've been working on for so long. I'm going to talk about titling your book. I'm going to talk about pricing, distribution. I'm going to talk about the forward. I've got some great opportunities to have some really good people do the forward. One of them, a national radio host that you would know if I were to mention his name. Don't want to jinx it. Turns out I grew up with this guy. We went to school together from kindergarten till I was in the 8th grade. I've known him all my life. He's a cool guy that I've got access to. Will he do the forward? I don't know. I'm going to take you along for that journey. There's another guy that I know. He's in the film and television industry. Very popular podcast. Maybe he would do it. I got three or four people that I'm looking to do the Ford. I'm going to take you along for that journey. I'm going to talk about endorsements. I'm going to talk about marketing. I'm going to talk about getting the word out about this book. Every single aspect of getting out a book. And I'm also going to talk about something a lot of people don't talk about, which is, this is scary for me. This is a brand new market. Like I said, 20 years in the music industry, that's how I'm known. That last book that I talked about doing, I still get emails, I still get tweets, I still get letters about how people love this book. Just a couple of days ago, doing a search on Twitter, saw a guy with a question, happened to answer it. He said, oh my gosh, I have listened to your book 50 times. Crazy that you're tweeting me. That's the kind of reaction that I get to my last book. That's the kind of reaction that I want to this new book. But will I be able to do it? Radio since the early 90s, syndicated show since 2005. That's when I started podcasting. So I've been around, but I'm not known as a podcaster. Will people accept me? Will people like this new book? It's going to be totally different from the podcast marketing books that you've seen. So it's a risk for me. I'm all in. Retired from the music industry for the last couple of years, trying to figure out what I'm going to do. And I'm all in this, betting everything. Will it work? Will it not? That's what we're going to find out. If you're not already subscribed to Red Podcast and you want to follow me on the journey over the next few weeks, here is the way to do it. Go to Red Podcast, R-E-D, like the color, podcast.com. In the top left, you'll see different ways to subscribe to Red Podcast. Choose the best option for you. Android, iPhone, however you get your podcast, I will send you the new episodes of Red Podcast, the top left corner of redpodcast.com. Subscribe and you will never miss an episode. And if there's something that you're wondering about when it comes to putting a book out, forming an idea, outlining, editing, writing, editing again, writing again. I've written this book four different times. That's how hard I'm working on this. Whatever your questions, reach out to me. You can do that at redpodcast.com. Thank you for listening. Look forward to sharing this journey with you. I'll see you on the next episode.